Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing about power screws. What is a power screw? It can be defined as a conversion of rotary motion into linear motion during power transmission. So these kind of energy transmission or the motion transmission we will be calling as a power screw. It produces uniform motion, and the design of the power screw may be such that either screw or the nut is held at the rest and the other members rotate as it move axially. Example, screw clamp. Or else either the screw or the nut rotates but does not move axially. Example, press. So we will be discussing all these things in this video, that is power screws, types of power screws, load analysis, efficiency of power screw, threads, applications of power screw. So types of power screws includes square thread, Acme thread, buttress thread and isotrapezoidal thread. So square thread. Among all the different types of thread, you can able to see even the pictorial view, square thread is the strongest thread and there is no radial load on it and it is very hard to manufacture since it breaks up very easily. So much higher intrinsic efficiency than Acme threads. This thread is difficult in machining them. And it is lower in friction and most efficient thread form, but is difficult to fabricate. And you can able to see the pitch value, that is from the center of the first thread to the adjacent thread. This is the pitch, and the pitch even can be defined as the height of the thread also. The angle between each thread is 90 degree. And moving to the second type, Acme thread. The Acme thread form has a 29 degree thread angle. Here you can able to see this is the 29 degree angle. So the half of the thread angle will be 14.5 degree and the pitch, as I told you, from this point to the next immediate point is the pitch. The apex with the thread height half of the pitch, this is also one of the important information about the Acme thread. So the half of the pitch will be the height of the thread. The apex and the valley are flat. This shape is easier to measure than a square thread. The tooth shape also have a wider base, which means it is stronger than a similarly sized square thread. This thread form also allows for the use of a split nut, which can compensate for nut wear. And moving to the next type, buttress thread. In machineries, the buttress thread form is designed to handle extremely high axial thrust in one direction. You can able to see here. The load bearing threaded face is perpendicular to the screw axis or at a slight slant, usually not greater than 7 degrees. The other face is slanted at 45 degrees. So great strength, only unidirectional loading. So these are all even some advantages and some drawbacks. Here I can able to see the height of this particular thread is 0.63 times of pitch, and this is 45 degrees, and the load, as I told you, it's unidirectional. One day and one direction will be there. And what is the tooth head surface is nothing but 0.163 times of pitch, and this is the angle of 7 degree. And next one is efficiency of power screw. A square threaded power screw with a single start is shown in the particular sketch, where P is the pitch, alpha is the helix angle, and DM is the mean diameter of the thread, and F is the axial load. In order to analyze the mechanics of the power screw, we need to consider two cases, that is raising the load and lowering the load. Here we can able to see the particular sketch where the development of a single thread only has considered to discuss the efficiency of the power screw. And here we can able to see the pitch, the helix angle, the collar, the force which is applied, the mean diameter, everything we can able to see here. And the diameter of one particular development of single thread, where the distance is measured as pi dm. And the efficiency of the power screw after the calculation, like you can able to see applied force and even a coefficient of frictional force, the reactional force with respect to this helix angle. So the forces at the contact surface for raising the load. So for this particular condition, the efficiency formula, where the power formula we will be getting it as F into mu cos alpha plus sin alpha divided by cos alpha minus mu sin alpha. F is nothing but the applied force, and mu is nothing but coefficient of friction, alpha is nothing but helix angle. And the TR, which is equal to P into DM by 2, which is equal to f of dm by 2 into mu cos alpha plus sin alpha divided by cos alpha minus mu sin alpha. And efficiency of the power screw is nothing but work output divided by work input. Here the work output is equal to f into l and work input is equal to p into pi dm. What is the efficiency formula we have checked, and we will now discuss the condition for self-locking. So the load would lower itself without any external force if pi mu dm is less than lead. So this is the formula for the self-locking, and some external forces are required to lower the load if pi mu dm is greater than or equal to L. Therefore this condition is called self-locking, and the condition opposite to this is nothing but overhauling. So self-locking is condition whether we are raising up the screw or we are lowering up the screw, some effort should be applied. Then that condition is nothing but like a self-locking. Without applying any effort or any kind of torque, if the load it is falling down automatically, then that condition is nothing but overhauling. And technically that can be defined as pi mu dm is less than or equal to L. And for the trapezoidal thread, the efficiency formula is the analysis is for square thread, and for the trapezoidal thread some modification is required. So because of the thread angle, the force normal to the thread surface is increased. So the torque is therefore given by T is equal to F into dm by 2 into mu pi dm secant square of pi plus L divided by pi dm minus mu L secant square of L. Fine. Here you can able to see here I am not used either cos theta, sin theta or tan theta. Instead of that I will be using a secant theta, that is nothing but inverse of the tan. So the increased friction is due to the wedging effect, but they are not preferred due to the greater losses due to the friction. And this is the efficiency of trapezoidal thread power screws. Here you can able to see this where this pi angle is there, and this is nothing but f by cos pi, the angle which was made, and even it can be denoted in the formula secant, and the thread angle is denoted as 2 phi. So therefore T is equal to f into dm by 2 mu pi dm secant phi plus L divided by pi dm minus mu L secant phi. So this is the formula to calculate the efficiency. And when we do the load analysis for the same lifting condition where tan lambda is equal to L by phi dp, this is the formula, and Tsu is equal to p dp by 2 into mu pi dp plus L divided by pi dp minus mu L. And the threads we can able to see where p is the pitch, and unit can be either in inches or in centimeters or mm. Usually we will be following two units only either are inches or mm. And d is nothing but diameter, major diameter inches, and dp is nothing but pitch diameter, again that is inches, and dr is nothing but minor diameter. And instead of d, dr, dp, here we can go to d, d1, d2 also we can use based on our own references and flexibilities. And L is nothing but lead. And applications of the power screws, we have screw jacks, lead screws of your lathe, screws for vices, presses, C-clamps, instant material testing machines, machine tools for positioning of table. And here you can able to see some of the examples where the lead screw is this one, and this is a bracket, and this is a lock nut. You can able to see this is very common everywhere, you can able to see, and it's a typical C-clamp. And more than 90% of the Acme nut threads have been worn away, allowing the jack screw to move freely. Even these are some of the applications of power screws. Thank you.